tanam tanam taganam dattaganam dattaganam daganam dada anam dada anam nam danam danam taganam nam taganam taganam danam danam taganam nam ta anam danam danam nam danam ta anam nam danam anam nam danam nam nam da nam da 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 da anam da nam da nam da da anam da nam da nam da nam da da anam da nam da nam da da anam da nam da nam da da nam nam da anam
da nam da nam da da. Hello and welcome to Raaga Rasika. This is a podcast program that explores the world of Carnatic music. Joining us from Albany, New York is Vidya Subramanian. Very early on in our series, we had featured a stringed instrument called the tambura. Today, we want to feature another stringed instrument in Carnatic music, the Veena. The Veena is a very ancient instrument in South India and is highly revered and respected in the field of Carnatic music. In fact, in Hindu culture, the Veena is believed to be of divine origin. In many depictions of the goddess Saraswati, who is also considered to be the goddess of learning, she is depicted with the Veena in her hand. Just as a side note, goddess Saraswati is the wife of Lord Brahma, who is considered to be the creator of the universe. Coming back to Veena, Vidya, could you tell us a little bit about the Veena itself?
The Veena is one of the most ancient musical instruments. There are several references to the Veena in Sanskrit as well as Tamil language literature and in many classic Hindu texts. As an example, the Meenakshi Pancharatnam, which is a set of verses composed by the legendary Hindu philosopher Sri Adi Shankara, who is believed to have lived sometime around the 8th century AD, includes a reference to the Veena. In the Meenakshi Pancharatnam, the goddess Meenakshi, who is one of the forms of the mother goddess, is referred to as Veena Venu Mridanga Vadya Rasika. That is one who enjoys the music emanating from the musical instruments such as the Veena, the flute, as well as the mridangam being an Indian drum or percussion instrument. In fact, the common Veena is also sometimes referred to as the Saraswati Veena. There are also references to the Veena in the Vedas, which are among the most ancient of Hindu literature. The modern Veena's origins can be traced to the Raghunatha Mela Veena, which was developed by Govinda Dikshitar in the 16th century.
Interesting, Vidya. The word Veena is something that one can come across very frequently and commonly in several Carnatic compositions. Vidya, could you share with us a few examples of compositions which have the word Veena in them?
The very first example that comes to my mind when I think about references to the Veena in Carnatic compositions is the Geetam or beginner lesson that many of us who have taken Carnatic music lessons would be familiar with. The lyrics start with the words Vara Veena Mridu Pani. In this Geetam, the goddess Saraswati is described as one who holds the divine Veena in her soft hands. Let me sing a couple of lines from this composition.
Vara Veena Mridu Pani Vanaru ಮೋಹಲೋಚನರಾಣಿ ಸುರುಚಿರ ಬಂಬರವೇಣಿ ಸುರನುತ ಕಲ್ಯಾಣಿ.
ದಿಸ್ ಗೀತಂ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರಾಗಂ ಮೋಹನಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಟ್ ರೂಪಕ ತಾಳಂ. ಟು ಗಿವ್ ಅ ಫ್ಯೂ ಅದರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್, ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಸೆವರಲ್ ಮುತ್ತುಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದೀಕ್ಷಿತರ್ ಕಾಂಪೊಸಿಷನ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಹಿ ರೆಫರ್ಸ್ ಟು ಗಾಡೆಸ್ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಆಸ್ ಒನ್ ಹೂ ಪ್ಲೇಸ್ ಆನ್ ದ ವೀನಾ. ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಕಾಂಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಇನ್ ಹಿಂದೋಳಂ ರಾಗಂ, ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ವಿಧಿಯುವತಿ, ಇನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಶ್ರೀ ಮುತುಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದೀಕ್ಷಿತರ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ಸ್ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಆಸ್ ಮುರಳಿ ವೀಣಾ ಗಾನ ವಿನೋದಿನಿ, ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಒನ್ ಹೂ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಡಿಲೈಟ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮ್ಯೂಸಿಕ್ ಪ್ಲೇಡ್ ಆನ್ ದ ಫ್ಲೂಟ್ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ದ ವೀಣಾ. ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಸಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಲೈನ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದಿಸ್ ಕಾಂಪೊಸಿಷನ್.
ಮುರಳಿ ವೀಣಾ ಗಾನ ವಿನೋದಿನಿ ಸಂವೇದಿನಿ, ಮುರಳಿ ವೀಣಾ ಗಾನ ವಿನೋದಿನಿ ಸಂವೇದಿನಿ, ಮುರಳಿ ವೀಣಾ ಗಾನ ವಿನೋದಿನಿ ಸಂವೇದಿನಿ.
ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಯೆಟ್ ಅನದರ್ ವೆಲ್ ನೋನ್ ಕಾಂಪೊಸಿಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮುತುಸ್ವಾಮಿ ದೀಕ್ಷಿತರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ರಾಗಂ ವೇಗವಾಹಿನಿ, ವಿಚ್ ಬಿಗಿನ್ಸ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಲಿರಿಕ್ಸ್ ವೀಣಾ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಧಾರಿಣಿ. ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಸ್ಕ್ರೈಬ್ಸ್ ಗಾಡೆಸ್ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಅಗೇನ್ ಆಸ್ ಒನ್ ಹೂ ಹೋಲ್ಡ್ಸ್ ಅ ವೀಣಾ ಆಸ್ ವೆಲ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಬುಕ್ ಇನ್ ಹರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಅಂಡ್ ದ ಸಾಂಗ್ ಗೋಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಫಾಲೋಸ್.
ವೀಣಾ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಧಾರಿಣಿ ಮಾಶ್ರಯ ವೀಣಾ ಪುಸ್ತಕ ಧಾರಿಣಿ ಮಾಶ್ರಯ.
Vidya, thinking about the Veena, one can also come across references to this instrument being associated with several other features in Hindu literature. Examples that come to my mind are that of Lord Shiva and the sage Narada. Another interesting tidbit is that Ravana, who is the villain of the Hindu mythological work Ramayana, is also considered to be an excellent Veena player. In fact, his flag is supposed to have a picture of the Veena on it. Coming back to sage Narada, who is a divine sage in the Hindu tradition and plays a prominent role in a number of Puranic or sacred texts, especially the Bhagavata Purana and in the Ramayana, is typically portrayed as a traveling monk with the ability to visit distant worlds or planets. He is usually depicted as carrying a musical instrument, the Veena.
That's right, Devesh. In fact, Tyagaraja has mentioned about Narada's musical prowess as well as his skills at playing on the Veena in his Kannada Raga Kriti, Sri Narada Nada. In the Pallavi or the opening segment of this Kriti, Tyagaraja likens Narada to a bee that hums around a lotus. In this case, the lotus being the sacred nada or divine music. And again, in the charanam or the concluding segment of the composition, he describes Narada as Veda Janita Varaveena Vadana Tatvagnya, that is, one who excels in the technique of playing on the Veena, an instrument which has its origin in the Vedas. Again, it's interesting to note here the reference to the Veena as having its origin in the Vedas. Let me now sing the Pallavi line of this composition.
Shri Narada Nada Sarasi Ruha Vrinda Shri Narada Nada sarasi ruha vrunga shubhanga shi naradana sarasi ruha vrunga shubhanga shi naradana sarasi ruha vrunga shubhanga shi naradana sarasi ruha vrunga shubhanga shi naradana
Now moving on to the Charanam segment.
Veda Janita Varavina Vadana Tatvajna Veda Janita Varavina Vadana Tatvajna Veda Janita Varavina Vadana Tatvajna
In yet another composition, Mokshamu Galada, in the Ragam Saramati, Tyagaraja talks about attainment of salvation. The lyrics of the Pallavi line go as follows. Mokshamu Galada, Bhuvilo, Jeevan Muktulu, Gani, Varalaku. The meaning of which is as follows. Tyagaraja in this composition asks if salvation can possibly be attained by a person unless he or she realizes the true self. The reference to Shiva as being one who obtains delight from the Veena comes in the Charanam segment. The lyrics that refer to the Veena go as follows. Veena Vadana Loludau Shiva Mano Vida Merugaru Yagaraja Vinuta. The meaning of this line is that Lord Shiva is one who obtains great delight from the music of the Veena, and Tyagaraja once again asks whether somebody who could not perceive the God in the divine music that comes from an instrument such as the Veena could possibly aspire for salvation. Let me sing the opening segment of the composition.
Moksha mugalada Bhuvilo jeevan muktulu ga
I'll now render the relevant segment from the Charanam of this composition, which has reference to the Veena.
Veena va Galada Bhuvilo
Thank you, Vidya, for those illustrations. Let's pause here and pick up next time when we will talk about the Veena as an instrument, its design, and how it is played. But for now, that's all the time we have. Join us next time on Raaga Rasika. Write to us at www.raagarasika.com. That's RAAGARASIKA.com. To learn more about Vidya, visit her online at vidyasubramanian.com. Thank you and goodbye. Ta na 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 na